Lovenox is an anticoagulant that helps prevent the formation of blood clots. Lovenox is used to treat or prevent a type of blood clot called deep vein thrombosis, which can lead to blood clots in the lungs, pulmonary embolism. A DVT can occur after certain types of surgery or in people who are bedridden due to a prolonged illness. Lovenox is also used to prevent blood vessel complications in people with certain types of angina, chest pain, or heart attack. How to use? Lovenox is usually given every day until your bleeding condition improves. Follow all directions on your prescription label and read all medication guides or instruction sheets. Lovenox is injected under the skin or as an infusion into a vein. A healthcare provider may teach you how to properly use the medication by yourself. Read and carefully follow any instructions for use provided with your medicine. Don't use Lovenox if you don't understand all instructions for proper use. Ask a doctor or pharmacist if you have questions. Prepare your injection only when you are ready to give it. Don't use if the medicine has changed colors or has particles in it. Call a pharmacist for new medicine. You should be sitting or lying down during the injection. Do not inject the medicine into a muscle. Your care provider will show you where on your body to inject Lovenox. Use a different place each time you give an injection. Do not inject into the same place 2 times in a row. You will need frequent medical tests to help your doctor determine how long to treat you with Lovenox. If you need surgery or dental work, tell your surgeon or dentist you currently use this medicine. You may need to stop for a short time. Store room temperature away from moisture and heat. Each single-use prefilled syringe is for 1 use only. Throw it away after 1 use, even if there is still medicine left inside. After your first use of a Lovenox vial, you must use the medicine within 28 days. Throw away the vial after 28 days. For prevention of blood clots after unstable angina, chest pain, or non-Q-wave myocardial infarction, a type of heart attack. Adults, dose is based on your body weight and must be determined by a doctor. The dose is usually 1 mg per kilogram of body weight injected under the skin every 12 hours, together with aspirin 100 to 325 mg once a day for 2 to 8 days. Children, use and dose must be determined by a doctor. For prevention of deep venous thrombosis, abdominal or stomach surgery. Adults, 40 mg injected under the skin once a day for 7 to 10 days. The first dose should be given 2 hours before the surgery. Children, use and dose must be determined by a doctor. For prevention of deep venous thrombosis, hip or knee replacement surgery. Adults, 30 mg injected under the skin every 12 hours for 7 to 10 days. Alternatively, for hip replacement surgery, the dose must be 40 mg injected under the skin once a day for 3 weeks. Children, use and dose must be determined by a doctor. For prevention of deep vein thrombosis in patients with a serious illness, adults 40 mg injected under the skin once a day for 6 to 11 days. Children, use and dose must be determined by a doctor. For treatment of acute deep vein thrombosis with or without pulmonary embolism. Adults, dose is based on body weight and must be determined by a doctor. However, the dose is usually 1 mg per kilogram of body weight every 12 hours injected under the skin for 7 days. Children, use and dose must be determined by a doctor. For treatment of certain type of acute heart attack. Adults, dose is based on body weight and must be determined by a doctor. However, the dose is usually 30 mg injected into a vein and 1 mg per kilogram of body weight injected under the skin, followed by 1 mg per kilogram every 12 hours injected under the skin for 8 days. Aspirin 75 to 325 mg once a day may be also given. Older adults, dose is based on body weight and must be determined by a doctor. However, the starting dose is 0.75 mg per kilogram of body weight injected under the skin every 12 hours for 8 days. Aspirin 75 to 325 mg orally once a day may be also given. Children, use and dose must be determined by a doctor. Contraindications. Known hypersensitivity to enoxaparin, urticaria, anaphylactic reactions, anaphylaxis, or any heparin products, active major bleeding such as gastrointestinal bleed, history of heparin-induced thrombocytopenia within the past 100 days of presence of circulating antibodies, history of hypersensitivity to benzyl alcohol in neonates. Benzyl alcohol is present in the multiple dose formulation of enoxaparin. Warnings. You should not use Lovenox if you have active bleeding or a low level of platelets in your blood after testing positive for a certain antibody while using enoxaparin. Lovenox can cause a very serious blood clot around your spinal cord if you undergo a spinal tap or receive spinal anesthesia, epidural, especially if you have a genetic spinal defect, a history of spinal surgery or repeated spinal taps, or if you are using other drugs can affect blood clots including blood thinners or NSAIDs, ibuprofen, Advil, Aleve, and others. This type of blood clot can lead to long-term or permanent paralysis. Get emergency medical help if you have symptoms of a spinal cord blood clot, such as back pain, numbness or muscle weakness in your lower body, or loss of blood or bowel control. Lovenox side effects. Get emergency medical help if you have signs of an allergic reaction to Lovenox, hives, itching, or burning skin, difficult breathing, swelling of your face, lips, tongue, or throat. Also, seek emergency medical attention if you have symptoms of a spinal blood clot, back pain, numbness or muscle weakness in your lower body, or loss of blood or bowel control. Call a doctor at once if you have unusual bleeding or any bleeding that will not stop, easy bruising, purple or red spots under your skin, nosebleeds, bleeding gums, abnormal vaginal bleeding, blood in your urine or stools, coughing up blood or vomit that looks like coffee grounds, signs of bleeding in the brain, sudden weakness, especially on one side of the body, sudden severe headache, problems with speech or vision, low red blood cell, anemia, pale skin, unusual tiredness, feeling like headed or short of breath, cold hands and feet.